गुड मॉर्निंग चिल्ड्रन. इन द प्रीवियस क्लास वी वर डिस्कसिंग अबाउट सेंस ऑफ द ईयर. ओके, सो इन दैट वी कंप्लीटेड एक्सटर्नल ईयर, मिडिल ईयर एंड इनर ईयर. सो एक्सटर्नल ईयर मीन्स वी नो दैट टिम्पानम विच हेल्प्स इन कॉन्सेंट्रेटिंग द साउंड्स. देन इट कंटिन्यूस एज हियर स्मॉल टाइनी हेयर्स एंड वैक्सी ग्लैंड्स आर प्रेजेंट. सेरेमोनियस ग्लैंड्स आल्सो विच आर गोइंग टू प्रोड्यूस ईयर बैग्स दट विल प्रिवेंट दि एंट्री ऑफ डस्ट पार्टिकल्स. एंड ईयर पिन्ना और एक्सटर्नल ईयर इज गोइंग टू हेल्प इन कॉन्सेंट्रेटिंग साउंड्स. देन नाउ वी ऑब्जर्व ए कैनाल लाइक स्ट्रक्चर विच वी कॉल इट एज ऑडिटरी कैनाल और ऑडिटरी मीटर्स. ओके, इट कंटेन्स दि chain of three bones which we call them as ear ossicles. They are the tiny bones of our body, incus, malleus and stirrup. So three structures or three bones are present in the middle ear. So now we will come to the very very important part, that is inner ear. Inner ear. So this inner ear, if we observe, it contains the bony labyrinth enclosing the membranous labyrinth. Is it clear to you? So this entire portion is having bony labyrinth, means made of bony structure and membranous labyrinth next. So now this portion we call it as vestibule, and the three semicircular canals, this portion we call it as a vestibule, and three semicircular canals and a spiral structure which we call it as a cochlea. Is it clear to you? So what are the important parts here? Semicircular canals, vestibule and cochlea. So now this vestibule, if we observe, the anterior part of this vestibule is a sacculus means it is fluid filled. And the posterior part of the vestibule, if we observe, it is utriculus, means there a large number of hair cells are present and they are going to help in passing the message of hearing to the brain. Is it clear to you? So this is said to be cochlea. So this vestibule, which is sacculus and utriculus, it contains as a large number of hair cells. So what it is going to help means, it form so many nerve fibers are given off, and these are going to form as a vestibular nerve. Then semicircular canals are filled with endolymph, and they are connected to the vestibule. This vestibule and semicircular canals form as a structure called vestibular apparatus. So this semicircular canals and vestibule, it forms as a vestibular apparatus. So from this vestibular apparatus, the vestibular nerve is given off, and this vestibular apparatus is going to help in, means this vestibule and semicircular canals are going to help in maintaining posture and equilibrium of our body. Means what? We are standing erect, we are sitting erect, we are receiving the information also properly through the ears. So that in a proper way it is happening because of a vestibular apparatus, which is because of semicircular canals and vestibule. Till now we discussed about the vestibule and semicircular canals. Now we will discuss about the cochlea, which is said to be the real sensory part of our ear, which helps in hearing. So this cochlea, if we see, it is spiral structure, which is spiral structure, and it has three parallel tubes. So what are those three parallel structures? Means scala vestibuli, scala media and scala tympani. The first two are separated. So three tubes are present, like we learn the cochlea, scala, vestibule, scala media and scala tympani. So
three.
If we cut this cochlea, so we can observe like this under, so round window, oval window we can observe there, and the scala vestibule and scala media are filled, are separated by vestibular membrane, and scala media and scala tympani are separated by, are covered by basilar membrane. Scala vestibule and scala tympani are filled with a fluid called perilymph. Scala vestibule and scala tympani are filled with the perilymph, and scala media is filled with the endolymph. So here the scala media contains the membrane of this endolymph, real sensory cells, primary sensory cells called chondrae, which are going to help in receiving the information about the hearing. So now the cochlear nerve and vestibular nerve, these nerve fibers, they connect together and form the nerve, which is given off from the ear to the brain, which we call it as a auditory nerve. Auditory nerve, which helps in passing sensory information to the brain.
So this is the picture of ear. Observe the ear diagram, parts of the ear clearly. So this is a pinna or external ear. It extends. Fine hair like structures also you can observe. So this is called ear canal or auditory meatus. Auditory meatus, and you can see here this eardrum. So eardrum is connected to three tiny bones, hammer, stirrup and anvil. So technically they are called incus, malleus and stapes. Is it clear to you? So these are the three bones, tiny bones, or ear ossicles. Ossicles means bones. Incus, malleus and stapes, three bones. Now you can observe, and this region is vestibule, and now end fibers you can observe, and this is a semicircular canals, and this spiral structure or snail like structure is called cochlea. Sensory part of the ear. So now auditory nerve, cochlear nerve, vestibular nerve, so they are together form auditory nerve. So this hair cells, chondrae, which are present in this scala media, which contain the sensory parts of hearing. So this picture is exclusively about the inner ear or internal ear. Is it clear to you? So now these are semicircular canals, and this region vestibule, and it continues cochlea. Is it? So now it is dissected. So you can observe here the different parts, oval window, inside that semicircular canal. So hairs sense movement, then nerve fibers, we can observe large number of nerve fibers, then round window, oval window we can observe, and nerve fibers which are given off, and all are how they are connected you can observe here.
Now we will discuss about how the ear works as a sense organ of hearing. So now the external ear helps in concentrating sounds. Okay, the sounds are going to pass all the way through the auditory canal and they are going to hit the eardrum. So we know that when the sound hit this eardrum, vibrations start. Okay, children. So these vibrations, then they are going to be transferred to through the inner part of ear, that is cochlea, through the ear ossicles, and the inner ear cochlear region that contains three parts already you learned: scala vestibule, scala media, and scala tympani. So this scala media, as it contains the endolymph and ear, the primary sensory cells of hearing are present, which we call them as corti, and they are going to analyze that sounds, and that sound vibrations are going to be carried to the brain with the help of nerves. So nerve fibers, cochlear nerve, vestibular nerve fibers, then they are going to be form as an auditory nerve, and that auditory nerve is going to carry information of hearing to the brain. Then we can able to enjoy the different sides, so different types of sounds. Let us recall once the functions of ear. So you know that what is the main function of ear means? It helps in the hearing. The main function of the ear as a sense organ, it is the hearing. Then another important function which is carried by the ear is said to be maintaining equilibrium and posture of the body, means balancing of our body is happening, that is because of inner ear, that is cochlea. Is it clear to you? So two important functions are going to be carried out by the ear. Ear as a sense organ hearing, and it helps in maintaining equilibrium and posture or balance of the body is going to happen because of ear. Till now we discussed about the structure of ear and functioning of ear. Now we will discuss about care of ear. To enjoy the sense of hearing and maintaining the good posture of our body, we have to take care of our ears. So first point, what we have to do? So the ear packs, whichever is produced, it is going to be filled. To remove that, we are not supposed to use any sharp instruments to remove that. So what we have to do? Earbuds we can use to remove them, or any lubricating drops of oil like coconut oil we can use to loosen, so that it is easy for us to remove the ear wax. Then second point is said to be, we are not supposed to pour hot oils into the ear, so it may cause damage to the ear, internal parts of the ear. Then if any problem is there, like any infection is there, fungal infection or bacterial infection, we can observe sometimes pus or sometimes blood bleeding also we can observe. So if such type of things are observed, then immediately we have to consult a doctor. What do we call that specialist who can treat the diseases related to ear? ENT specialist. Okay, ear, nose, throat. So ENT specialist we have to consult, and we have to take a treatment for that particular type of diseases. So what are the common diseases here? Are infections, bacterial infections or fungal infections will be seen. So they or sometimes dangerous, so we have to go to the doctor and we have to go for a treatment. Thank you.